Marcy, you stay in the car. I'll be right back.
Simon!
Ow, 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 ow!
You're not going to put it on, are you?
I have to protect us.
But you're gonna act weird again.
Don't worry, I can control it better now. It's okay. BRB. Ah!
What are you talking about? You're scaring me.
I'm sorry, did I say something?
Simon, promise me you won't put it on again.
Okay, I promise.
Look, this clipping, this was you, Simon, before the war. This, you took this picture.
Hey, check it out, a VHS tape. You want to watch a movie?
Yeah.
Man, this is a boring movie. I like the book much better.
You're so silly, Simon.
Yeah, I suppose so.
What had I said? What had I done when I wore this crown? All I know is I never saw Betty again. Since then, I now see the visions always, whether or not I wear the crown. Tell me the secrets of the ice and snow, that the power of the crown will save me with its frost. I don't yet know what this means. As you can see, my skin is beginning to turn blue. My body temperature has been lowering at a supernatural rate to what is now about 30 degrees Celsius. I don't know when it will end. I'm really scared. I know my mind is changing, but I'm already too far gone to know what to do. I want people to know that if I do things that hurt anyone, please forgive me. Just watch over me until I can find my way out of this labyrinth in my brain and regain my sanity. And then maybe Betty, my princess, maybe you will love me again. Please love me again, Betty.
Together, Simon. For her.
Simon, your hair and your nose are longer, and you started to hover in the air.